Welcome to Betty's Cooking Channel. Today I will be making chickpea burgers. Here are the chickpeas I have here in the cup. I soaked them overnight. Then using the dried beans and soak them overnight. And they become pretty soft. So what I'm gonna add to my ninja is a shallot. I'm gonna have that, I'm gonna place it in the ninja and have it chopped up. A slice of red onion, baking soda, salt and pepper. I'm gonna use a little cumin and some onion powder and also some yellow mustard. A pinch of pepper flakes, pinch of pepper flakes, and some oregano. So let's get started. I forgot to mention I'm gonna use just a little spelt flour. Add the salt in here, salt and pepper in the container. My shallot. I probably should cut it in half at least. Maybe I will do that. If I can get it out of here. Okay, I'm gonna cut it in some smaller pieces. Was a half a teaspoon of cumin and half a teaspoon of onion powder. And I'm gonna add some mustard. A teaspoon of mustard. I added a teaspoon of mustard. Pinch of pepper flakes. Some oregano. That's about 2 teaspoons. Teaspoons of oregano. And I'm gonna use I would say a half a cup of parsley. Let's blend this up. Aquafaba in here. This is from soaking the beans. This is the water from the beans. I'm going to add some spelt flour. Add in grapeseed oil. And about, I think all together, probably a half a cup of spelt flour. Okay, this is the consistency that you wanna have so that you can make your burgers. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my my stove. So I can start heating up the oil for the burgers. I'm gonna turn it on medium high. And start heating up the oil. And just place one chickpea burger in the oil there in the skillet. taste good, and you don't feel guilty when you eat them. It doesn't take long to cook them, so let me find a plate to place them on. Turn this one over now. I have got a cup of grape seed oil. I'm using grape seed oil to fry these in. Instead of buying the frozen vegan products, this is an easy recipe you can use. Instead of buying the frozen stuff, at least you know it's fresh, and you can put whatever ingredients you like in your chickpea burger. This is a good alternative to not eating meat. You want to kind of cut back on your meat intake. This is a great recipe. And you're getting your protein and everything from the chickpeas. Go ahead and turn this one. I think it's ready. Just want to flip it the opposite way. I don't want to flip it toward me. The amount of chickpeas that I use, I will make at least 9 burgers. This is my last chickpea burger, and you notice it's a little bit larger than the other ones. If you like this video, like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends and family. Have a wonderful day.